Hello everyone, in our last video of the problems of India and their solutions, in this we have covered the topics unemployment, corruption and discrimination. Now next we will deal with communalism. Communalism is a major problem in our country. Segregation in the name of religion and creating hatred and cultivating opposite self-interest can be called as communalism. Now next we will see the effects. It creates social differences, mutual suspicions and fear situation in the society. Political competition, social groupism and economic hatefulness is expressed in communalism. Communalism has the capacity to endanger the integrity and the unity of India. It is not only disturb the peace of the society, it also destroys the public and private property. It leads to mutual allegation and physical assaults and other undesirable effects. Assault means a violent physical attack. It is called as assaults. Communalism puts self-interest ahead of national interest. The communal forces makes attempt to increase their communal forces in the country. They attempt to preach their religion and also tend to be suspicious of other religion. This affects the unity of the nation. As a result, the country has to spend a lot of energy to maintain internal peace and order. Now we will see what are the measures or solutions. A lot of precautions are needed to address the challenge posed by communalism. Ideas like uniform civil code, equality among all the citizens, supporting secular values in the society and transcending narrow thoughts in favor of national interests can be the solution for communalism. Economic and social inequality could fuel the communalism. Attempts should be made to foster the faith of all the people and develop healthy national thoughts. Precautions should be taken to check communalism as it could spoil the integrity, equality, fraternity and cultural diversity of India. The citizens should commit themselves for a secular society. Now next problem, it is status of women. The achievement of women during pre-independence India are notable. Jhansi Rani Lakshmi Bai, Kittur Rani Chinnamma, Annie Besant, Kasturba Gandhi, Savitri Bai Phule, Sarojini Naidu are some of the memorable women freedom fighters. Now, women are present in all walks of life like medical, teaching, engineering, police, politics, military and other areas. Still, the status of women need a lot of improvements. The status of women has remained low due to the social customs, poverty and illiteracy. This has affected the progress of the country. Now we will see what are the measures or the solutions to improve the status of women. The government has started women and child development departments in order to develop women education and status. Many programs have been implemented to control child marriage system. Dowry Prohibition Act, compulsory education are implemented as a means of empowering women. The government of Karnataka has implemented Stri Shakti program through which self-help groups of women are formed and fostered as a means of social progress. Different cooperative formations like Stri Shakti, self-help groups or association of self-help groups have been formed. Women commissions have been established at national and state level to address the different issues of women. Attempts are made to provide reservation at the state and national legislature bodies. Women reservation has already been provided at local bodies. Women reservation is also provided in government requirements. Now next, we have to deal with terrorism. Terrorism can be called as extremism. This is a method putting pressure on a government. Terrorism based on political ideologies, religious faith and ideological beliefs create a lot of loss for the individuals as well as communities. Moreover, terrorism creates psychological pain and influences the cultural aspects negatively. Terrorism is nothing but fulfilling its narrow end by creating panic and violence. It feeds on fear of the people. These are organized crimes supported by organized group of people. Such activities are called anti-national and anti-social acts. Bombing of the World Trade Center of USA, bomb attacks on Bali of Indonesia, bombing different cities of France, Britain and other countries are the reasons for worries at the international level. The terrorism is based on extreme religious sentiments, separatism and racialism. Often a country founds and supports terrorism is another country. Terrorism targets civilians of the country, military base, and also targets specific community with specific language, religion, race, skin, and color to create maximum terror among them. It aims at creating more fear by killing people. India is one of the countries in the world that has been target of terrorism for many years. Terrorism was there in the states like Nagaland, Manipur, Kashmir, Punjab and other places. There was attack on Taj Hotel in Mumbai on November 26, 2007. Similarly, the parliamentary house had also been the target of terrorism. Terrorists have targeted places like Hyderabad, Chennai, Bangalore and other places to create panic. Now next we will deal what are the measures to control the terrorism. India has always criticized terrorism in other countries also. Our central and state governments have taken at most care to stop terrorism. They have always strived to protect the property and the life of ordinary people. They have even created special elite. Elite means superior or intellectual forces to tackle these terrorists. India has been a peace-loving country and has undertaken many initiatives to stop terrorism. The next last problem it is corporate strategy. First we'll see what is the meaning. The corporate strategies have been the biggest challenge in front of the Indian society since the beginning of 21st century. A group administrative measures undertaken by a company to achieve a premeditated target is called corporate strategy. Here premeditative means which are planned earlier in advance, it is called as premeditative. The present day corporate strategies are using globalized environment and modern technologies. The main aim of this are maximizing the profit of the company. This affects the people, the society and a country negatively. Often the corporate strategy influence the decision of the government also. On the positive side, some corporate companies can be employed to alleviate social problems like poverty, malnutrition, health, skill training and many other aspects of the society through corporate social responsibility programs. Alleviated means to remove. The government need to mandate such initiatives through appropriate legal measures. Only with such initiatives, the Indian society can channelize the corporate strategy in favor of the society. Here we have finished all the 7 problems, their reasons as well as their solutions. If you are having any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. Thank you.